I'm trying to fix the teleporter, but it will take some time. Quickly! Run! There's an elevator on the right side. Run to it! Don't try to fight them. You don't have time.
Get through.
Turn around and run to the right. The power source is there.
Yeah.
You are not going anywhere.
Don't fight her! Just get to me!
Shut up, sister.
Oh no! She's locking me out!
Silence. Let's concentrate on our fight, shall we?
I'm constantly underestimated, but no longer. I will deal with you. There's no way out for you now. After I kill you, I'll teleport to my stupid little sister.
If I have to die here, I want to finish you first.
Don't interfere, sister. By now, the torch don't work.
Don't you see?
You're wrong. I'm just starting.
Thank you.
teleport. We have just a few seconds.
What about Minikin?
Minikin stays. You go now.
Minikin, I think I can teleport you too if I'll...
No! No time! Must explode now! They hear!
Minikin.
Good luck! No, forget Minikin!
Never. You're the best.
Launch! Launch now!
The small exploration ship managed to activate its faster-than-light propulsion just a split second before being devoured by the gigantic explosion that hopefully destroyed the ESS Meridian together with the infestation and dimensional nexus. It was a long journey to Tau Ceti. The heroes of the story spent it alternating between dreamless sleep and hibernation pods and making frantic repairs needed to keep the battered ship going. When they finally arrived, they immediately took their failing ship down to the planet, hoping to find a place where they could safely land with their ship intact. It didn't work as well as they had hoped. But they survived the crash landing and began their new life on the planet's surface. It was a life full of adventures and mysteries, and a story for another day.